Hello everyone, welcome to my channel where nothing is too hard, everything is talked about, life, death, and I share things that happen to me. And this video just happened to me, so I want to put it as a warning. I need to find vocational training for 160 hours because I'm doing a diploma in alcohol and drugs and a diploma in mental health. So that vocational training for 160 hours is over 2 years. Now, there are many places that you can advertise, and I haven't yet advertised on Seek. I've advertised on Gumtree. Now, Gumtree, I think, is Australian. But anyway, last night at 7 o'clock, I missed two calls, and they were from a private number. At 12 o'clock today, Saturday, private number rings again. So I ring it up because I'm very sus, you know, the calls could be, you know, scammers wanting money. So I very tentatively said, hello. This male voice said, hi, Jem. It's either Tony or Trevor. And the funny thing is you know those voices that give you the creeps, you know? The voices of some crime boss or some serial killer or some, you know, that those husky, really deep voices that just send shivers and chills up your spine. Well, this is what happened, but okay, you know, you can't help the way you speak, so yeah, okay. And he said he was from Allied Health. And I said, yes. And he said, were you on Seek? And I said, no. I said, I was on Gumtree. And he said, are you looking for a job? And I said, no, I'm a student looking for vocational placement. And he said something about medical health. And I said, no, alcohol and drugs and or mental health. And he said, well, I'm from Allied Health, and that's perfect. That's exact. We've got a section in there, and we're looking for someone like you who's mature. Now, on Gumtree, I've got my face. So employers or organizations can see who they're getting. Anyway, he said, we're looking for mature employees like you. And he proceeded to tell me, and this is where it gets a little bit unprofessional. He said to me, oh, you know, RNs with their drugs and alcohol have stuffed up. And I went, yes. And since COVID have stuffed up. And I said, yes. And he said, well, me and my wife, we're in our 30s. We run this practice and we have 12 RNs. Now, for one, that's confidential. He shouldn't be telling me whether his staff are under the influence or anything about his staff. And he said to me, we're looking to employ someone who can do drug tests. Who, you know, can do drug tests on our staff because, and before he said that, he said, the only difference between you and the rest of the staff is that my nurses can prescribe drugs and everything and you can't. But we're looking for someone to do drug tests on our staff. And I'm starting to get a bit sus here because I'm a student. I don't know how to do I don't know how to do drug tests. You know, that's police do drug tests. I'm not a police. And not only that, you can go to the chemist and get a drug test. And if you're an employer, you should have a policy knowing how to do drug tests. Not employ a student. How does he not know that I don't need, you know, he's taking at face value someone who's going to be testing his employees if they have been using drugs and alcohol. But I, what about me? Maybe I've used alcohol and drugs, you know? And I've thought this is starting to sound really, really a bit sus. And so I said to him, thinking, all right, because I was also in the process of making Sahara's dinner. It was lunchtime. I need to wrap this conversation up pretty quick. And maybe he needs, you know, I'm getting really interested here because maybe this is legit and maybe he's going to train me to be able to do this. And maybe this is a job opportunity. Anyway, I thought, well, if he's going to do this, he'll need character references. He'll need, because he asked me what qualifications I had, and I didn't tell him. I said to him, I'm a student at TAFE, you know, who's going to be studying, but I do have postgraduate qualifications. And I thought I would ask, so I needed, you know, more information. And because I didn't want to waste hours on the phone, I thought it would be better if we did this in email and I could send him more information, all these character references. I could send my postgraduate qualifications. I could send him any information he needed. So I said to him, what's your email address? Immediately, he hung up. And I'm thinking, what the F just happened? Was I the unprofessional one for asking for his email address? Why? What's going on? So immediately I ring my therapist because I don't know if I'm doing the wrong thing. Because say there's a legit job offer and I have just been rude by asking, you know, for an email address. You know, maybe that's not protocol. So I rang my therapist and I told her the story and she said, no, you did nothing wrong. The fact that you asked for his email address and he just hung up shows it was dodgy. She said there, and I said, sorry, I'm getting a bit ahead of myself. I said, what was he after? What? Because he wasn't trying to scam money, yet he knew my phone number. He knew my name. He said, hi, Jem. I didn't offer my name. I was just tentative and said, hello. Anyway, I said, what's he after? What was that for? Was it just so he's lonely and he decides to ring up and get off on listening to my voice? Or was he about to set me up and lure me to some address and I'll never be seen again? Or what was it? Because the whole thing was just off. And she told me that one of her clients, this is my therapist, one of her clients, his girlfriend, had something similar happen. She had signed up to, again, a similar thing, that was offered a job. So the people offering her a job said to her, do you mind if we send a computer to your place? So, because this computer has, you know, so you can, by working for us, this is our computer, shows that you're going to work for us and blah, blah, blah. Next minute, they get there, early hours in the morning, they get barged into, it's the federal police, hidden in the computer was cocaine. So was I being set up for a drug thing? Leave your comments below if something similar has happened to you, or can you tell me what was this guy, what did you think this guy was after? And am I correct that you can go to the chemist and that an employer would not employ a student? I haven't even started studies. I can't take blood. I don't know how to take blood. I don't know. I can go to the chemist and get, you know, the drug test that they say there and get people to spit or urinate or however they do the drug test. But can you comment below? What do you think the guy was after? And did I do the right thing asking for his email address? Again, I've also got to step back a bit and tell you that I have to find vocational placement, and I've already tried 6-7 different organizations. So when someone says to me Allied Health, that sounds very similar to some of the places I've applied to. And just because it's a Saturday didn't, you know, ring alarm bells, because some medical practices are open on a Saturday. And but the guy didn't sound 30, and he sounded very, very creepy, very, very fishy. So please tell me, what did this guy have to gain by ringing me up and offering this weird job? Do you think he was luring me into drugs? Okay, I really do want to know. I am, when it comes to street wise, I'm sometimes very clueless. I've been scammed before for money. I've been scammed before on, you know, dating apps that they want to come over and have sex straight away. But what was this guy's angle? Okay, cherish every moment. Love the best you can. And please warn others about this scam. This is dangerous. And do you think I should go to the police? But what can I go to the police? It was rung from a private number. I've got nothing. I can't give the police anything. Just this random guy with a very scary voice rang me. All right, this is my video for Saturday, and it truthfully just happened just over an hour ago. Love you guys. Enjoy your Saturday. Bye for now.